Ready to rock and roll. Woo!
Take four strangers.
When did you lose your virginity?
Throwing four very different dinner parties.
It's not her evening, it's my evening.
Mix in some secret scoring.
It's very old hat.
Quite sophisticated.
And you get weirdness.
It looks like a bad nappy, doesn't it, really?
Whinging.
I was actually going to eat more.
I just can't be dealing with it tonight at all.
Oh, dear.
And warring women.
Neither of them are talking to each other now.
The woman's disgusting.
Before one of them walks away with a £1,000 prize.
We look like that film Pose. 9.5 weeks.
This week we're in West Lincolnshire, famous for its sausages, meat stuffed into synthetic skins. And talking of unnatural exteriors, meet this week's first host, plastic surgery fan Jo Allen.
I've had my boobs lifted and reduced, I had my love handles taken out, and the most thing that I absolutely adore is my tummy tuck. I have got a four-pack stomach.
And jewellery importer Jo is just as proud of her rebellious youth as she is of her appearance.
I was the wild child of Britain, with a leather skirt and fishnet tights, hanging out with Amanda de Cabinet.
Amanda de Cabinet? Was she friends with MC Hammock?
A woman who I would like is somebody sweet-natured, very sweet, not too in your face.
I have an opinion on everything. You can ask me a question and I will say to you, yeah, I've got an opinion on that, I've got an opinion on that, whatever.
Any thoughts on plastic surgery? Competitor number two is feisty conservatory saleswoman Margaret Hope, who'll happily answer any question, apart from one.
I don't think a lady should discuss anything about her age. You can ask me how old I am, but I'm not going to tell you.
She's 51.
Moving on.
Getting back to tonight's host, 40-year-old Jo is cracking on with her starter, chicken skewers with a crunchy satay dip.
This is getting a bit old hat, all this now. I think all this Thai stuff.
Don't lean back, whatever you do. Picky contestant number three is straight-talking roofer Nigel Reed.
At the end of the day, I'm just a hairy-bum roofer. What you see is what you get.
Doesn't look that hairy to me.
I consider myself to be an alpha male. You know, I like being with the lads. I like going out to pubs with the lads. I like going on stag weekends.
I've been a drag queen now for 16 years under the name of Miss Candy Cane.
I'd love to see you down the pub with Nigel. Last of this week's lineup is cabaret artiste Justin Hussey.
I love being a drag queen because you can be as outrageous as you want, you can pick on people and they find it funny and you can just have a whale of a time.
Meanwhile, Jo's making her satay dip by frying red onion in sesame oil before adding crunchy peanut butter.
I tried to make this with roasted peanuts, but the consistency came out very, very lumpy, even after I processed it.
What, like that? She adds coconut milk, lime and chilli flakes before setting the mixture aside to be reheated later. Next, it's on to her dessert, iced lemon mousse surprise.
Maybe it won't be lemon, it'll be orange or something like that. Maybe that'll be the surprise.
Wrong.
I have a jewellery business and I'm going to give everybody a little gift. However, I don't have really any gifts for the men, so they're just all going to have to get the same.
Just the thing for a hairy-bummed roofer. Jo beats together cream, lemon curd and lemon juice in a bowl before adding condensed milk.
My food isn't home cooking. It's more on the restaurant standard.
Even if you do say so yourself. She finishes off the desserts by layering the mixture into dishes with more lemon curd and leaving them to set. Which just leaves one course to prep, the main, crispy duck breast in a morello cherry sauce.
I wouldn't say that I've ever used cherry in cooking.
I've never had crispy duck at anyone's house before. I don't think I pulled that one off.
Jo starts her prep by, hang on, that's not your kitchen.
I can't wait for tonight. I'm so looking forward to it. I think things are going to go quite well for me. I think I'm on track. Mm-hmm.
Well, a bit of cooking wouldn't go amiss.
Oh, that's great.
Sure your hair's high enough.
Super duper.
Yeah, when you're ready, love. Finally, back in the kitchen, Jo whips up her sauce using dried cherries, red wine and cherry jam. She'll cook her duck later on, so after a quick change of clothes, there's just time for her to rustle up some cocktails.
Well, I'm not making them that strong. Just the usual.
Just the usual half a bottle of rum. And first in to try Joe's lethal concoction is the lady who would hate you to know her age, 51-year-old Margaret.
Hello! How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, welcome to the house. You look great.
Thank you.
Look at you.
These are for you, okay? And I've chosen yellow because it's for friendship.
Oh, bless you.
Oh.
There you go, one mojito.
Oh, that's lovely.
Pleasure to meet you. Let me go and get my drink.
Okay, great stuff.
It's always awkward when you're wearing the same outfit as someone else's cushions, isn't it?
Ooh, powerful.
Next up, it's Nigel, who scrubs up quite well for a hairy-bummed roofer.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Okay,
how are you? I'm Joe. Nice to meet you.
Hello, Nigel. Pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
Very nice.
It's all left a hanging.
Yeah, okay. Sure.
And finally, it's drag queen Justin.
Hello.
Hello, darling. How are you?
How are you?
Nice to meet you. Oh, you too. What's your name? Justin. I'm Joe. Hello, Justin. Pleased to meet you. Smile. Double kiss.
Clearly, she's not taking no for an answer this time. What, you two as well? Kisses all round then.
Here's to a good week.
Yeah.
Cheers, guys.
Coming up, sneaking suspicions.
You've got a friend in me, darling.
Oh, bless you. Maybe just gotta watch that one.
Raunchy revelations.
Look.
A mirror above the bed.
Is this a bit of fun?
And uncomfortable confrontations.
Can I ask you something? Do you have a problem with me at all?
Joe's probably more outspoken than I took her for.
Yeah, cheers.
In West Lincolnshire, self-styled former wild child Joe Allen is entertaining three strangers in a bid to win a £1,000 prize as top host.
Do you want to see my fish? Do you like...
I'm sorry?
You've got to see this, right? I dare... Who's going to put their finger in? They haven't got teeth.
I don't know. He looks pretty ferocious to me.
You saw my finger. Come on, baby.
No, probably it's going to say
it's
no.
Warm,
false nails, it'll probably say.
They're not false, honey.
Oh, you're not. You're joking. Oh, look at mine. Mine have just, like, come
these
off
aren't
with the stick-ons. No, good for you.
Come on, baby.
I really like Margaret, but I said something about the nails, and immediately she bit. I thought, right, well... Maybe just gotta watch that one.
I'm sorry, but I don't have fake nails. These are my own nails.
And they're not bad for a 51-year-old.
I think I'm feeling the effects of the alcohol a little bit.
Maybe you shouldn't have put quite so much rum in your cocktails then.
It looks like a bad nappy, doesn't it, really, don't you think?
I'd rather not look.
Okay, here we go. My saute chicken.
And Joe's starter is ready to go. Chicken skewers with a crunchy satay dip.
I've had satay sauce that's been, you know, just smooth before, but not like this. It's lovely like this. Mm. Bit of texture.
If I was in a restaurant, had that starter, not a problem. It was good.
The plates were cold, which is a bugbear of mine. I don't like cold plates.
So, Joe hasn't lived up to Margaret's exacting standards yet, but it looks like the ladies are bonding in other ways.
Me and you, Joe, are going to be good friends.
You know something, seriously.
We are, darling.
There is something about you.
You meet people for a reason.
Mm.
It's like a boat.
A what?
If you can imagine a boat going down a stream or a river and people get on and off your boat.
Yeah, not too sure about this.
And, you know, sometimes you like people who get in your boat.
Yeah,
and other people you don't like. You want them to get out of your boat.
And sometimes you want to jump overboard.
You know what means the world to me is I really want to meet some friends.
Well, you've got a friend in me, darling.
Oh, bless you. Margaret actually says she likes me. And I'm her friend, and you've got a friend. But a little part of me says, no, maybe not.
That boat journey didn't last long.
2 gallons of it.
I've decided my breasts are too big, so I'm going to make them smaller.
Not more plastic surgery. Oh, do you mean your duck? Thank goodness.
Hey, I'm going to stick these on now.
Jo pan fries her poultry and heats up the cherry sauce she made earlier.
Oh, it's not crispy enough. That's what somebody's going to say, I know.
Well, you did call it crispy duck on your menu, so they'd have a fair point.
I know there's going to be a moan about the place tonight. It's like, why have you thrown everything in such a corner with such a big plate? It's like, well, you know, whatever.
Just as long as they're warm enough for Margaret. Here it is anyway, what was supposed to be a crispy duck breast with a side order of empty plate.
You missed a bit, look.
Oh.
The duck is really nice, but it's not very crispy.
Mm. You're not going to get a crispy breast, so I've been told, which I thought you could. Sorry.
When you look at a menu and see crispy duck... you expect to have crispy duck.
You can't fault his logic.
The duck was a little bit overcooked for my liking. It wasn't as pink as I liked.
Again, I felt the plate. It was cold. It wasn't warm.
Oh, dear. If crockery controller Margaret's not put off already by the cold plates, she's about to be hit with the question she hates most.
Margaret, yeah. Do you mind me asking you how old you are? Because I think you look... I would say about 43.
What does it mean? People say, how old are you? How old are you? Does it matter?
In other words, you're not going to tell them how old you are. She's 51.
She's obviously got a thing about her age. I mean, that's up to her. I'm sure in the next 2 or 3 days we'll find out how old she is.
I wouldn't bet on it.
I'm not going to tell you how old I am. I don't want to tell you, I don't need to tell you, and I'm not going to say.
It's all right, we already know. Time for dessert, if Joe can sober up long enough to serve it.
I'm feeling rather drunk, actually. Feeling really quite merry.
I wouldn't worry, I don't think you're the only one.
I am a little bit inebriated, yes.
Oh, you'll regret that tomorrow. But at least you don't have a dessert left to prepare. In the kitchen, Joe's attempting to zest a lemon with a bread knife.
Very drunk. Right.
Please do not try this at home. Somehow she manages to plate up dessert. Iced lemon mousse surprise. The main surprise being that she didn't injure herself making it.
Oh, I've got this.
I know, but you've got that. I've got this and mine's chipped.
You've got a little present.
Can I look at my surprise?
Hopefully you'll give it to a partner, a very good friend. Simulated diamonds.
Don't think they're that impressed.
Lemon mousse, I don't know what people think of it.
It's very nice, Jack.
It's very light.
Yeah. Is it?
No, it's light, it's fresh. That's a good word. Mm.
This was the surprise we got, the imitation diamond earrings, which I don't think was very well thought out, really, seeing as we had two men there tonight. I'll probably give them to my mum for Christmas.
Bit tight.
They weren't diamonds, so I don't wear anything that's not diamond.
Well, you definitely can't wear anything you don't even take home with you.
One person left the present, which was good old Margaret, left the product. She thought it was amazing and how sweet the present was and so on.
Yeah, she's not American.
But she left the present.
The food's been okay, but not fantastic. So I'm going to award Jo a 7.
I'll give her a 7.
My starter plate was cold.
Uh-huh.
My main plate was cold.
Right.
And my dessert plate
was cold.
Chips on both corners.
Oh, fair enough then. So, some slip-ups with her tableware means Jo scores just 19 out of 30. It's day 2 and Ruth and Nigel's turn to try for the £1,000 prize, but all eyes appear to be on the two women.
I don't think Margaret really wants to be my friend. She wants to be my friend, but I don't think she does.
I think both Jo and Margaret are both strong women and very opinionated, and I think there could be a clash of characters.
I thought Jo and Margaret got on really well.
Typical bloke, no idea. Our unobservant host is getting things started with his dessert, Nigello's very special trifle.
Dessert? Well, if I know Nigel by now, that's going to have a lot of alcohol in it.
Well, clearly you do know Nigel by now.
There's port in the jelly, sherry in the sponges, and there's avocado in the custard.
He adds his port jelly to the base and leaves it to set while whipping up a homemade custard using his third alcoholic ingredient, avocado. Exactly the last thing a certain person needs.
I feel dreadful today. I really do. Tonight I'm going to pace myself a little bit, you know, take my time and maybe drink a little bit more water in between.
Luckily for Margaret, though, Nigel's at least whipping up some classic hangover fare for his main, a medley of Lincolnshire sausages with a root vegetable mustard mash.
Nigel, I love you. That's just what I need tonight. Oh, my God, I need some proper stodge.
Hopefully he's aiming a bit higher than that. Nigel will be cooking his stodge later, so all that's left is his starter of homemade pâté with toast.
Not too keen on coarse pâté, but it all depends on what he's going to do.
Nigel starts by frying chicken livers together with bacon, garlic and red onion.
Now the messy bit, I've got to blitz it.
After blending the fried ingredients, he adds cream, port and egg yolks before returning the mixture to the heat.
Simple food with nice ingredients.
He adds stock and bakes the pâté in a bain-marie before slipping into something in keeping with his dress code for tonight.
Bad taste. I don't really know what that is. I don't really do bad taste.
Bad taste to me means clothes that you wouldn't mean seen dead in, which obviously I haven't got anything like that in my wardrobe.
I don't know. You've got that T-shirt.
I don't know if Margaret will understand. I think Joe definitely will.
Ready to rock and roll.
Now that's what I call bad taste. Oh, mind your back, Grandad.
If all the guests haven't made an effort tonight, I'll be absolutely... Well, I'm not devastated, but I won't be very happy.
No need to worry about that. Joe seems to have understood the theme.
Hello, it's Nigel. Actually, you'll do. Oh, you look brilliant. I just don't know. I feel really bad. I haven't got anything outrageous.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were dressed in bad taste.
Hello.
Who's she talking to?
No, it's just me.
I'm first in tonight.
Next in, it's Justin, who appears to have come as Elton John.
Hello. Hello. Nice.
How you doing?
Right, Justin. Right. Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Shall we vote then? Is Margaret... is it going to be girls normal and boys dressed like idiots?
I think Margaret will probably just have a nice pink top on and a nice lemon top.
No, she's actually made an effort, Joe.
Margaret!
You've never seen a man in a wig before.
Oh, you look tremendous. Oh, lovely.
Nice to see you again.
Have you got a hangover?
No.
No? Oh, God.
Why?
I felt really bad all day.
Did you?
Oh, how are you? Nice to see you. Oh, wow, you look really
80s. Oh. Two people out of three made the effort tonight for the bad taste to be silly and just have a laugh. But obviously Joe didn't.